Mina, Konbanwa, Jesus Freaking Gamer here. Joshua chapter 4, starting at verse 1. And it came to pass, when all the people had completely crossed over the Jordan, that the Lord spoke to Joshua, saying, Take for yourselves 12 men from the people, one man from every tribe, and command them, saying, Take for yourselves 12 stones from here, out of the midst of the Jordan, from the place where the priest's feet stood firm. You shall carry them over with you, and leave them in the lodging place where you lodge tonight. Now get this picture. The priests step into the river. The river parts. Specifically, like I said yesterday, like the water's backed up all the way over here, and then the water down here is just kind of trickling into the Dead Sea and just kind of disappearing and going away. And you got an entire army crossing over. So this river's probably parted for several hours. Very, very likely. That's easy to believe. So you've got all these people crossing. Then after all the people have completely crossed, then God says, oh, by the way, Joshua, get 12 men, grab 12 stones from the middle of the river, and then plant those stones at the place where you're going to lodge later. Now, in an earlier video, I talked about how God sets up landmarks. He's doing that again. God likes to set up several landmarks because we humans, we can be simple creatures. We need a lot of reminders. I know I personally cop to that big time. But that's actually not the point. I'm not driving that point home again. The point I'm driving home is, you've got the entire army crossing over, miracles happening, rivers being parted, the whole army's crossed over, and then God's like, oh, by the way, send 12 guys into the middle of the Jordan while the guys carrying the ark are still there, get them to find 12 stones. And so they do that. And then skip over to verse 15, still Joshua chapter 4. Then the Lord spoke to Joshua, saying, Command the priests who bear the ark of the testimony to come up from the Jordan. So they've got their stones. Time for the priest to come up from the Jordan. Joshua therefore commanded the priest, saying, Come up from the Jordan. And it came to pass, when the priests who bore the ark of the covenant of the Lord had come from the midst of the Jordan, and the soles of the priest's feet touched the dry land, that the waters of the Jordan returned to their banks and overflowed all its banks as before. If you read in earlier chapters of Joshua, it was harvest time, and the banks of the Jordan overflow at harvest. So it wasn't even normal height. It was really, really high. What I got from this when I was reading it, when the Lord is doing something, whether it's you crossing into the promised land or the Lord's just doing something kind of amazing in your life, I find it very easy to start doubting midway through, like, is the Lord really in this? I believe the Lord started this. Sometimes the doubts come, did he really start it? And even if I believe he started it, is the Lord going to keep this awesome thing going? Is it going to keep happening? Is it going to keep being amazing? That kind of touches my heart a little bit deeply, and it seems to be something that I've talked with a lot of Christians about personally, where it's kind of like, you know, something awesome has happened and God is so good, then there's this fear in the back of your mind, is it going to keep being awesome? Is God going to keep being good? And in this verse, right, in the verses in this chapter right here, that water didn't move until the Israelites were completely out of the way. And not only had the army crossed, but after the army crossed, God was like, by the way, send some guys back in there and get them to get 12 stones. So the whole army's crossed. The big thing that needed to be done was done. The army's crossed. The miracles happened. Now 12 guys need to go into the river all by themselves. No army. No one but them, and the priests have got to keep standing there, keep bearing the Ark of the Covenant for a little bit longer. They've probably already been standing there and bearing it for hours, and they've got to keep doing it for a little bit longer. Is God going to keep being good? Is the miracle going to keep happening? Can we not be afraid that God's going to let us down now? Sometimes in the middle or near the end of whatever awesome thing God's doing, sometimes we lose faith, sometimes we lose heart. I know I still do. And I feel like in this, I just found an answer. I thought that's what I was supposed to preach on tonight. And just as I'm talking, I'm kind of discovering with you guys, as I'm talking, an answer to something I've been thinking about for a while. And something that in the middle of all the blessing that I feel like I've gotten recently, that I know I've gotten recently, is God going to keep being good, or is just the next horrible thing around the corner? And I'm sure bad things are going to come. I mean, they did have to go into combat after this, and they did have to fight. And you'll find out shortly as I keep on reading, because I read the Bible just, you know, chapter after chapter. I just read it from Genesis to Revelation. I don't have a specific rhythm or pattern. I just read a chapter a day. And you're going to find that there were sacrifices. Bad things did happen after this, especially when the people were disobedient. But God doesn't stop being good. And whatever he's begun, he's going to finish. We can trust him for that. Now, God, if you would please make this awesome thing that I just saw heart knowledge, not just head knowledge for me in Jesus' name. That would be awesome. That ministered to me. Didn't even honestly plan on that. Like I said, I kind of got that as I knew I was supposed to talk about God working with people, you know, midway through the miracle, after the miracle's done. Is God going to keep going all the way through? Is the miracle going to keep happening? Is God going to keep being good? It kind of opened up to me as I was speaking to you guys. So that was awesome for me. Hopefully it was awesome for you guys as well. I love you guys very much. God bless.